There are two planets that orbit between the Earth and the Sun, Venus and Mercury. Occasionally, those planets will cross across the face of the Sun in what's called a transit. There's a transit of Venus coming up in 2012, and there won't be another one for 108 years. But Mercury goes across the Sun every few years. I'd like to show you how to project a transit so that you and your friends and family can see it using simple materials you might have around the house, like a pair of binoculars, a couple sheets of cardboard, and a tripod. Now, you don't ever want to look directly at the Sun. So to do that, to save your eyesight, you have to get a pair of safe solar viewing goggles. And that's what I have here. They're only a couple dollars, and your eyesight is well worth it. So you can wear those and look at the Sun and see the tiny dark dots of the planets moving across the face of the Sun. Now, if you'd like to make it a social experience and project this for friends and family, you can do it with a pair of binoculars or maybe a monocular. It's actually a very simple setup, which we'll show you how to do next. And what you're going to want to do is face the open end of the binoculars towards the Sun and the eyepiece towards a white piece of paper. And then you want to align it up so that the sunlight comes in and through the binocular and goes onto the paper. And you must be very careful never to let anyone look through the binoculars at the Sun. So to do that, holding it in your hand is not going to work because the image will dance around. So we mount the binoculars or the monocular to a tripod or some sturdy fixture. To do that, I took these old pair of binoculars and I just epoxy glued a 1/4-20 bolt onto it, because the standard fitting on a tripod is 1/4-20, and I can just screw the tripod right into my pair of binoculars. For my monocular, I made a V out of metal, and I just Velcroed the monocular onto that V. And also, the V I attached with a 1/4-20 nut to my tripod. That lets me line it up. Now, to line it up, what I have to do is to point it so that the shadow of the monocular is a circle. If the monocular is pointed to the side, it'll have a rectangular shadow. If it's pointed at the Sun, it makes a circular shadow, and that tells me it's pointing at the Sun. But I can't see the image of the Sun right now because the sunlight is shining on my white surface, wiping out the image. So what I have to do is to take a shield, a sun shield, which is this piece of cardboard, and place it over the monocular. And I might have two holes for binoculars if I did that. Okay? And that gives me a shadow. And now I have to actually find my image. And this takes, there it is. So I know I was close. There it is. And then I can lock down the tripod. And I have now an image of the Sun onto my view screen. Right now, there are two tiny sunspots on the Sun that if I get really close, I can see. But the dark black disk of Venus, which will be small but sharp, or the disk of Mercury, will be amazing to watch in their stately march across the face of the Sun.